I might watch the intro. It's been a long time since I've seen it. Then vegan achievement, so no killing animals or eating them. Very limited food. And I can't build. I think that the stick bag and the archery bag are going to be the biggest pain, because that means I can only carry limited arrows and spears. So attacking things is going to be harder. Yeah, we watch this intro. My little son Timmy. Nice playing. I watched Vlad, is it? He played one of the older versions of this. And he is right, the intro looked better on the old version, and all the clouds especially. Started a new game in ages, everything's gonna look so different. Bit of turbulence. Wake up to some cannibal in red taking your son away. Now, this is going to be fun starting from the beginning. Have to remember, don't kill any animals. Going for the vegan achievement. I left the passenger list last time as well. Make sure I get everything. The food respawns in the plane, so it's not a bad idea to build a base close by. Well, and the plane crashes in different locations every time as well. As you can see, this is not where I crashed last time. Gonna start collecting stuff. I wondered if you could eat cannibals in the vegan achievement. I know it sounds stupid, but it just says no killing or eating animals. And you can obviously kill the mutants, because you have to make it in the game. You start with nothing. You don't even start with a map. You've got to find that, and then from that point on, you start mapping everywhere you've been. Okay, let's build a little hunter's shelter here, so I've got a save point. And then we will find out exactly where we are. If I save, if I accidentally hit an animal, I can go back to my last save.
Need to find someone that can borrow that VR set, although I'm pretty sure my computer wouldn't handle VR. I'm only playing this on a laptop.
Maybe we can carry 5 rocks, and I'm never going to be able to build the bag that lets me carry more. Okay, hunting shelter. This is the most simple shelter you can build that doesn't disappear. If you build the other one, you can only sleep in it once. Saving it as many times as you want, but as soon as you sleep in it once, it disappears. So many deer, and I can't kill them. Might play this for another 3/4 of an hour. See how far I get. I'm not gonna look anything up, any of the locations either, or obviously I've played it before, so I will recognise some places and some things. Wow, my energy is so low. What is it? Yeah, you start with your stats at 20. It can go down to 10. And up to 99. I think I'm around 60 on my other character, so I can run a lot longer. And we've got a save point. Let's make a spear. So if you don't know how to make anything, put an item in the middle and then hover over it, and it'll give you a list of everything you can make with that item. I can only carry one spear. How do I make a bow? Like that. So I'll make everything I can at the moment. Okay, I have no idea where I am. Oh, is this the hole? Am I right next to the sinkhole? I am. Okay, that's good. One of the big, largest things in the map, so it's quite easy for you to find. And then the other largest thing being the north-facing mountain. So now I know, I pretty much know where I am. That's cool. Oh my word, I am not ready for concentration yet. This weapon is rubbish.
Let's hope she doesn't find me.
You'll see how this map looks before I did all my building on the previous game. So just down here was where I built all those traps. And my little base. These tents you can save in. That's why I built here, it was an easy save point. Which means there should be a cave up here. Hopefully not a really dangerous one, because I'm not ready for that. Caves are scary, but you have to go in them. It's where the best stuff is. I really hope this isn't the one that's just got the big mutant at the bottom. I'm gonna die straight away. I've got a feeling there's something important in this cave. Can't remember what. Because I'm playing online as well, when I die, I'm not gonna get taken back to the main cannibal camp, which you do on single player. The first time you die, you get taken back there as a prisoner. The second time, it's game over. Multiplayer, it's game over straight away, and I just wake back up on the airplane with nothing again, and all my stats reset. Oh, there is something here, I can't remember what though. This is where playing the game is going to help a little. Oh, there's loads of mutant babies. Those things are strong. And I've got nothing to attack them with. It's right at the bottom of the rope, that's why I'm trying to avoid going down it, but I don't want to get four damage either. Kinda lucky that I survived. Whoa. Not let these things hit me, they take away so much health. Oh Jesus. I knew this was a bad idea before I got weapons and things. Okay, good. They're all dead. I'm half dead. Let's get some pills. I'm thirsty, but I haven't got that much stuff on me, so I'll wait. All my hotkeys are different. Change this. I thought this was taking me outside for a minute, but it's not. I'm just on the corner of the sinkhole now. I think maybe the climbing axe is down here. I kind of hope it's the sword, but I don't think it is. Like that weapon. Enemies don't respawn in caves though, so that's the good thing. Is that someone stood there? Add a bit of cloth to my axe as well, actually. Give me a bit more light. Ooh, yeah. Fire damage is going to help me as well. I'm so weak at the moment as well, obviously. You do more damage when you're stronger. So it takes less hits to kill things. Oh no, babies, that's bad. You've got to kind of let them run to you. Just sidestep them a little bit. Whoa, I do not want to get hit. Imagine playing this in VR. Crazy mutant babies flying at your head. Ah, strike down. If you burn bodies, you get bones. Bone armor is this to burn down, get my bones. The first time you can go through caves, it can take a long time because you're just forever replacing the armor that you lose. I combined that just in time, didn't I? The fire damage really helped. Same, usually get, oh there it is. I was gonna say you usually get 6 bones per body, but which is 1 piece of armor. You can see my armor in the bottom corner, I've just got 1 now. I think lizard armor is half the strength, and the big mutant armor, the creepy armor, is twice the strength. More babies, Jesus. Okay. Oh, hit it in midair, nice. Oh, Jesus, that just made me jump. Not expecting to look up and see someone. Let's get up this rope quick. Okay, so there's two cannibals and some mutants. Mutant babies. I can do this. Oh, I've got booze, I can make Molotovs. So dark in caves as well. Kinda worked. Oh, damn, I really need to set my hotkeys. Did the other one die from the fire? Yes, he did. Nice. Oh, he's still here. Woof. Cool, it is climbing out. Going towards my armor collection. Right, I'm doing pretty well. Killing your first whatever is usually really hard because obviously you've got no weapons, no armor. Sometimes it doesn't light if it thinks it hasn't got enough like time left on the cloth that you put on or something. Ooh, I got a picture. Picture of a chainsaw. I didn't know whether this was going to be a good game to stream or whether it was just going to be boring for people because it takes a while. The first time I played this, I think I always had 1 piece of armor. Anytime I got 2, then I'd lose it in the next battle. I've definitely got better. Okay, let's get out of here. I know, obviously, there's loads of this cave I haven't explored. This was the main item in it. I can always come back in.
Ich will nicht lösen, wenn sonst von den anderen Fängen.
Oh, here we go. Wow, I'm getting better at this game. Oh, Jesus. Oh, dang, it's three of them. Okay. Oh, I've got no stamina. My stamina sucks. Quickly drink something that would give me some stamina. Oh, they just took away all my armor. Fights are just so hard, you've got no stamina. And you're weak, so it takes a lot more hits to kill something. Come on then, where are you? Oh, what? Still two left. I think you'll die if you fall down, I don't know. That didn't work. Axe. Oh, I need to go down there really, because I need the bones. Looks like we're going back. Let's throw that dead body down there too. Oh, it won't let me. Still alive down there. Okay, how can I just have to burn this one and then go down to get the others? Kind of got myself onto this little ledge so I didn't die straight away. Gives me time to do this. Oops. At least he's on fire. I am going to end up with more armor than I started with. Even when I get good at this game, sometimes you just have a bad fight. Speed's like almost more important because you interrupt their attacks. Like the katana's not very strong, but it's so quick. You just end up slicing them. Yeah, it's gone, hasn't it? Yeah, so the bones from the one that I burnt have gone at the top. That sucks.
It's so dark. I've got lights in. I've got caves now as well in my upper game.
Oh. I don't know what happened to it. Maybe you just died of fire damage at some point. I will take your bones, sir.
I got this game and it was on offer, half price, but I think it's only £14 or something now. It's well worth it. And I'm just trying to get more people to play it, because I want to you do get six of each body, so one body, I just missed one. So, three pieces of armor. Ooh, what the? Any bones? Oh, it was going to give me extra armor from there. Is that? I thought that was one crouching down there, but it's just a reflection. You can do stealth kills, because in the caves, often they are just crouched down sleeping. Stealth, if you hit them in that position as well, they die a lot easier. Crossbow or even slingshot, you can do stealth kills with. Slingshot I never use, I don't know why. Just never seem to. Ah, damn. Cave water will make it cold. Maybe you've got to be in it for 11 seconds or something, I think.
As I'm north, I might as well carry on going north and pick up the flare gun, which is in the other half of the plane. And I think although the plane crashes in different places all the time, is that blueberries? Yeah. Food. Which I'm definitely going to need. Oh, I can't even have a blueberry pouch. Oh, Jesus. Crocodile. And I can't even attack it. Yeah, geez, how do you... Someone was saying online, oh, you can plant blueberry bushes. But how do you collect blueberry seeds without a pouch? And you can't make a pouch, because that involves animal flesh. That's a shame, that was going to be kind of my plan to survive. You can't grow any gardens. How do you pick anything without that pouch? I don't think you can. It's not like I can wait for a rabbit to die of natural causes and skin it. I should be swinging my weapon, really, to up my strength. You can up your strength 2 each day. I assume that's the same for stamina, but I'm not sure. The only way to upgrade your strength is by swinging a weapon, though.
Really,
I thought you'd get it from carrying logs, apparently not. You don't actually take cold damage unless you stand still though, so as long as you keep moving.
And the cave behind it obviously won't exist.
It's not quite where I was. I thought it was the other side.
You can achieve one when I stream, so you get to see the whole story.
And the cave behind it obviously won't exist, because that cave is only exists at the end. I might only play this vegan achievement one when I stream. So you get to see the whole story. Oh, you can only carry 5 stones. I am doing a few similar things than I did in my other one. Okay. Having a save point here. It's just so handy. Trying to not make it exactly the same, but it's turning out that way.
Just remember to take a few side steps every now and again, because if you stay still too long, you'll start taking cold damage. Carry 2 logs. I was building things 1 at a time before I realised you could get 2.
Sticks are really scarce around here. Although they're, you get these like big trees, or big stick trees, I should say. The smallest trees, they give you sticks instead of logs. But wow, my stamina is so low. All of this work for a few sticks. Save point. I can sleep because I obviously didn't the first night. Okay, there's nothing I to really do here now. I was just looking at my food and I almost killed a bird. I'm gonna have to keep saying to myself that I'm going for the vegan achievement. Don't.
I just wonder what else I could build. Arrows, I need feathers. Feathers, I need. Let's.
Feathers, I'm gonna need a birdhouse. Because I can't kill the birds to get the feathers, so that's the other way you get feathers. If I just put one on one of these trees, hopefully every time I come back to this base I'll pick them up. Wherever it is. Birdhouse, one log, four sticks.
I might call this stream out a day after that, so I've been going a little while.
And there, I'm gonna get attacked. Oh, Jesus. Get out of the cold for a start, because. Whoa. Oh, yeah, they can kill each other. If they start fighting amongst themselves, must be almost dead. She's just gonna run off. Okay, I'm gonna carry him back. My birdhouse. That give me feathers. I need feathers to make arrows. You can find them in the game, but being able to make them is gonna be handy.
Let's go in the
fire. Look at my stats. See, they can go up 2 each day, and I think I've been here 2 days here, 1 day. Starts on day 0. So it is something that you naturally build, but not as fast as you can. It's good to focus on it sometimes. Oh jeez, I just knocked the fire and broke it. I hope that body still burns completely. I'll make another fire in a minute. Don't know how long that fire will last without the stones. But cool, save. I'm gonna call it a night. Thanks for checking in the stream. And yeah, I think I'm gonna carry on with this vegan achievement. I'll just do it online, so I'll be streaming a lot more often until I've done this.